आज हम पढ़ेंगे क्लास 10th ज्योग्राफी का चैप्टर नंबर 7 लाइफलाइन ऑफ नेशनल इकोनॉमी। इस वीडियो में हम क्वेश्चन आंसर्स को पढ़ेंगे, तो चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं वीडियो को। लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन आंसर्स। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, इफिशियंट मींस ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट आर प्रीरिक्वायर्ड फॉर द फास्ट डेवलपमेंट। एक्सप्रेस योर व्यूज इन फेवर ऑफ दिस स्टेटमेंट। आंसर, आई एग्री विद द अबव स्टेटमेंट। विदाउट इफिशियंट मींस ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट नो डेवलपमेंट कैन बी मेड इन अ कंट्री। The arguments in favor of the statement are as mentioned below. The goods and services do not move from supply locations to demand locations on their own. The movement of goods and services from supply locations to demand locations necessitates the need for transport. A large number of workers are engaged in doing this work so that the needs of people may be fulfilled. Traders too use transport facilities for sending and receiving goods for selling to the consumers. If no transport facility is available, they may not be able to send their goods and products to different places. Their trade will thus be concentrated to one place only. The pace of development of a country thus depends upon the production and movement of goods and services to all the parts. Next question. Do you agree with the view that transport, communication and trade are complementary to each other? Explain your views. Answer, yes, means of transport, communication and trade are complementary to each other. As mentioned below, transport and communication provide the industrial basis for conducting trade. The growth in trade also leads to creation of more infrastructure to match the value of trade, because increase in the volume of trade may need more means of transport. More trade creates avenue for investment in infrastructure through the revenue generated by trade. The growth in trade means more transport, like road, railway, air, water and pipelines to be developed to keep the wheel of economy moving. Communication help in commercial transactions to be completed across different places all over the world. It helps to cross the geographical barriers and keeps the traders informed about their business instantly. The modern means of communication such as email, mobile, etc. are of great help for the traders all over the world. The world has become a village. Thus, it can be said that progress in science, technology, means of transport and communication are responsible for increase in trade and commerce. Next question, describe the different kinds of roads according to their capacity. Answer, the roads are classified into 6 classes according to their capacity as mentioned below. Golden Quadrilateral Superhighways. It is a major road development project linking Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, Mumbai and Delhi by 6-lane superhighways. The object of these superhighways is to meet the requirement of fast movement of traffic in the country and to reduce the time and distance between the mega cities of India. North-South corridor connects Srinagar, Jammu Kashmir to Kanyakumari, Tamil Nadu. East-West corridor connects Silchar, Assam to Porbandar, Gujarat. These highways projects are being implemented by the National Highway Authority of India, NHAI. National highways. National highways link extreme parts of the country, including one state with another. These are primary road system of national importance. Therefore, these are constructed and maintained by the Central Public Work Department, CPWD, on the central government. The historical Sher Shah Suri mark is called National Highway No. 1 between Delhi and Amritsar. A number of major national highways run in north-south and east-west directions. State highways. These roads link a state capital with different district headquarters. These roads are constructed and maintained by the State Public Work Department in state and union territories. District roads. These roads connect the district headquarters with other places of the district. These roads are maintained by the Jilla Parishad. Rural roads. Rural road or village roads link rural areas and villages with towns. A अंडर प्रधानमंत्री ग्रामीण सड़क योजना प्रोविजंस हैव बीन मेड टू लिंक एवरी विलेज इन द कंट्री टू अ मेजर टाउन बाय एन ऑल सीजनल मोटरेबल रोड. दस इट इज होप दैट द कंडीशन ऑफ रूरल रोड्स विल इम्प्रूव इन फ्यूचर. बॉर्डर रोड्स, दीज रोड्स आर द बॉर्डर एरियाज ऑफ द कंट्री. बॉर्डर रोड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विच इज़ अ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया अंडरटेकिंग कंस्ट्रक्ट एंड मेंटेन्स दीज रोड्स. दीज रोड्स आर ऑफ स्ट्रेटेजिक इम्पॉर्टेंस इन द नॉर्दर्न एंड नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न बॉर्डर एरियाज. दीज रोड्स हैव इम्प्रूव्ड एसेसिबिलिटी इन एरियाज ऑफ डिफिकल्ट टेरेन. दीज रोड्स हैव ऑल्सो हेल्प्ड इन द इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट ऑफ दीज एरियाज. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, हाउ रोड्स आर क्लासिफाइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द टाइप ऑफ मटेरियल यूज फॉर देयर कंस्ट्रक्शन. आंसर, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ टाइप्स ऑफ मटेरियल यूज फॉर देयर कंस्ट्रक्शन रोड्स आर क्लासिफाइड इन टू टू टाइप्स एज मेंशन बिलो. मेटल्ड रोड, दीज रोड्स आर मेड ऑफ सीमेंट कॉन्क्रीट और इवन बिटुमेन और कोल तार. वन कैन गो फास्ट ऑन मेटल रोड. दीज आर ऑल वेदर रोड्स. दीज आर मेंटेन्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट. अनमेटल्ड रोड, दीज आर नॉट ऑल वेदर रोड्स. दीज आर मेड ऑफ मड एंड ग्रेवल विच आर जनरली फाउंड इन द रूरल एरियाज. दीज आर समटाइम्स मेड इवन ऑफ सैंड एंड लेड एज एक्सटेंडेड रोड्स. दीज मे नॉट बी फिट फॉर यूज इन रेनी सीजन. द अनमेटल्ड रोड आर मेंटेन्ड बाय कॉमन पीपल. वन कैन नॉट गो फास्ट ऑन दीज रोड्स. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, डिस्क्राइब द प्रॉब्लम्स दैट आर बींग फेस्ड इन रोड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन इंडिया. आंसर, द प्रॉब्लम्स दैट आर बींग फेस्ड इन रोड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन इंडिया आर एज गिवन बिलो. इनएडिक्वेट नेटवर्क इन व्यू ऑफ द वॉल्यूम ऑफ ट्रैफिक एंड पैसेंजर्स. हाफ ऑफ द रोड्स आर अनमेटल्ड दैट कैन नॉट बी यूज ड्यूरिंग रेनी सीजन. नेशनल हाईवेज आर इनएडिक्वेट टू मीट द रश ऑफ ट्रैफिक. रोड्स इन द सिटीज आर हाईली कंजस्टेड. Most of the bridges and culverts are old and narrow. Roadside amenities like emergency health service, police protection on the highways are not adequate. The above problems need immediate attention of the government to make road transport more popular and useful in the country. Next question, railways are the principal mode of transportation in India. Explain. Answer, the railways are the main artery of inland transport in India. It is the lifeline of the country as mentioned below. Railways are the principal mode of transportation for freight and passengers. The Indian Railway have a network of 7,031 stations, 7,817 locomotives, 5,321 passengers service vehicle, 4,904 other coach vehicles and 228,170 wagons as on 31st March 2004. The total length of railways is 63,221 km. Railways are useful in conducting business, sightseeing, pilgrimage, along with transportation of goods over longer distances. It is the largest public network undertaking in the country. Thus, it is clear that the railways are playing an important role in our country. It had played an important role in the integration of the country as people can go far from one region to another easily. Next question, analyze the physiographic and economic factors that have influenced the distribution pattern of railway network in our country. Answer, physical and economic factors have influenced the distribution pattern of the Indian railway network in the following ways. Northern plain, level land, high population density and rich agricultural resources has favored development of railways in these plains. However, a large number of rivers requiring construction of bridges across their wide riverbeds posed some obstacles. Peninsular region and the Himalayan region. It is a hilly terrain. The railway tracks are led through low hills, gaps or tunnels, so it is very difficult to lay the railway lines. The Himalayan mountain regions too are not favorable for the construction of railway lines due to high relief, sparse population and lack of economic opportunities. Desert of Rajasthan. On the sandy plain of western Rajasthan too, it is very difficult to lay railway lines, which has hindered the development of railways. Swamps of Gujarat, forested tracts of Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and Jharkhand. These are also not suitable for the development of the railways. The contiguous stretch of Shyadri could be crossed only through gaps or passes, ghats. Although the Konkan Railway along the west coast has been developed, but it has also faced a number of problems such as shrinking of track in some stretches and landslides. Next question. Describe the problems being faced by the railways. Answer. The problems being faced by the railways are as mentioned below. Old track and poor state rolling stock. The major problem faced by Indian Railways is that the tracks are old and outdated. These old tracks cause many serious railway accidents. This has also resulted in speed restrictions. Travel without tickets. A large number of passengers travel without purchasing tickets. Indian Railways have to bear extra loss of about 5 crore every year on account of traveling without tickets. Railway accidents. The incidence of railway accident in our country is greater as compared to other countries of the world. Accidents occur due to the errors and negligence of the employees. Attack on railways. During disturbances or strikes, people attack railway stations. This leads to loss of railway property. For instance, there was a heavy loss of railway in the movement of West Bengal, Telangana and Assam and other places in the past. Lack of modern management. There is a lack of modern management as railway failed to attract suitable talent. It also could not make economic analysis for prescriptive planning tariff. Outmoded technology. The rolling stock technology is outmoded. This has made railway incapable of coping with increasing transport demand and of rising and improving the traffic volume and flows at lower unit cost of operation. Problems of laying double lines. Most of the railway lines are single lines, which create great inconvenience to the railway organization and passengers. Competition with road transport. The competition with road transport is harming the railway. The lack of coordination between railways and road transport has lowered the earning capacity of the railways. Next question. What is pipeline transportation? Give any 2 points of importance of pipeline transportation or explain uses and advantages of pipeline transportation. Answer. Under pipeline transportation, now pipelines are used to transport crude oil, petroleum products and natural gas from oil and natural gas fields to oil refineries, fertilizer factories and big thermal plants. Advantages. Crude oil and other petroleum products can be transported to far away inland locations like Barauni and Panipat. Pipelines have proved beneficial for gas-based fertilizer plants. Solids can also be transported through a pipeline when converted into slurry. Running cost of pipeline is minimal, but initial cost of laying pipeline is high. There are no transshipment losses or delays. Networks of pipeline. There are 3 networks of pipeline transportation as given below. From oil field in Upper Assam to Kanpur, Uttar Pradesh, via Guwahati, Barauni and Allahabad. It has branches from Barauni to Haldia via Rajmund, Rajmund to Marigram and Guwahati to Siliguri. From Shalaya in Gujarat to Jalandhar in Punjab via Virangam, Mathura, Delhi and Sonipat. It has branches to connect Koyali near Vadodara, Gujarat, Chakshu and other places. Gas pipeline from Hazira in Gujarat connects Jagdishpur in Uttar Pradesh via Bijapur in Madhya Pradesh. It has branches to Kota in Rajasthan, Shahjahanpur, Babrala and other places in Uttar Pradesh. Next question. Describe the inland navigation waterways in India. What are its advantages? Answer. India has inland navigation waterways of 14,500 km in length. Out of these, only 3,700 km are navigable by merchandised boats. National waterways. The following waterways have been declared as the national waterways by the government. The Ganga River between Allahabad and Haldia, 1,620 km, national waterways number 1. The Brahmaputra River between Swadia and Dhubri, 891 km, national waterways number 2. The West Coast Canal in Kerala, Kottapuram, Komman, Udyog Mandal and Champakarka Canal, 205 km, national waterways number 3. The other inland waterways include the Godavari, Krishna, Barak, Sundarbans, Vachingam Canal, Brahmani, East West Canal and Damodar Valley Corporation Canal. The advantages of waterways are as given below. Waterways are the cheapest means of transport. They are most suitable for carrying heavy and bulky goods. It is a fuel efficient transport. It is environment friendly mode of transport. Answer. India has a long coastline of 7,516.6 km. There are 12 major and 181 medium and minor ports. These major ports handle 95% of India's foreign trade. The major seaports of India are as given below. Kandla in Kutch, Gujarat. Kandla is a tidal port. It caters to the need of handling of export and imports of highly productive granary and industrial belt stretching across the states of Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan and Gujarat. Mumbai Port, Maharashtra. It is the biggest port with natural and well-sheltered harbor. Jawaharlal Nehru Port was planned with a view to decongest the Mumbai port and serve as a support for this region. Marmagao Port, Goa. It is the premier iron ore exporting port. This port accounts for about 50% of India's iron ore export. New Mangalore Port, Karnataka. It exports iron ore from Kundrimukh mines. Kochi Port. It is the extreme southwestern port which is located at the entrance of a lagoon with a natural harbor. Tuticorin Port, Tamil Nadu. It has a natural harbor and rich hinterland. It handles cargoes to Sri Lanka and Maldives too. Chennai Port, Tamil Nadu. It is one of the oldest artificial port of India. It is next to Mumbai in volume of trade and cargo. Visakhapatnam Port, Andhra Pradesh. It is the deepest landlocked and well-protected port. Paradip Port, Odisha. It specializes in the export of iron ore. Kolkata Port, West Bengal. It is an inland riverine port. It is a tidal port and requires constant dredging of Hooghly. Haldia Port. It was developed as a subsidiary port in order to relieve growing pressure on the Kolkata port. Next question. Describe the air transport in India. What are the advantages of airways? Answer. In India, air transport was nationalized in 1953. Domestic air services. These services are provided by Indian Airlines, Alliance Air, private scheduled airlines and non-scheduled air operators. International air services. These are provided by Air India. Helicopter service. These services are provided by Pavanhans Helicopter Limited to Oil and Natural Gas Commission in its offshore operations to inaccessible areas and difficult areas like northeastern states and the interior parts of Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand. Neighboring countries. Indian Airlines provides services to the neighboring countries of South and Southeast Asia and the Middle East. The advantages of airways are as given below. It is the fastest and most comfortable mode of transport. One can reach his destination at far away places within a short period. It can cover very difficult areas like high mountains, dreary desert, dense forest and long oceanic stretches easily. It is very useful in hostile areas and natural and human-made calamities like flood, famine and earthquakes. Next question, which are the main means of mass communication? Explain the importance of radio and television as an effective mode of mass communication in India. Answer: radio, television, newspaper, magazines, books and films are the main means of mass communication. The importance of radio and television as an effective means of communication in India is due to the factors are mentioned below. Radio and television provide entertainment to the people. These create awareness among people about various national programs and policies as debates are conducted on television and radio. Programs are broadcasted in different languages for all types of people. Doordarshan, the national television channel of India and one of the largest terrestrial network in the world, broadcast various types of program from entertainment, educational to sport, etc. for different age groups. Next question, write a short note on how tourism as a trade has flourished in India. Answer, the tourism as a trade has flourished in India as mentioned below. There has been increase of 23.5% during the year 2004 as against the year 2003 and contributed 21,828 crore of foreign exchange. Over 2.6 million foreign tourists visit India every year. Over 15 million people are directly employed in tourism industry in the country. It promotes national integration because people from India also go from one place to another place. It helps in the development of international understanding. Foreign tourists are attracted by Indian culture and traditions. It supports local handicraft and cultural pursuits because tourists purchase many products during their visit. Just visit India for visiting places of heritage or to have adventure in hilly region or to have business with India. Rajasthan, Goa, Jammu and Kashmir and temple towns of South India have attracted many tourists from all over the world. Next question, modern means of transport and communication serve as lifelines of our nation. Justify this statement by giving supportive arguments. Or efficient means of transport are prerequisites for the fast development of the country. Express your views in favor of this statement. Answer: India is well linked with the rest of the world despite its vast size and diversities because of efficient means of transport and communication. They are rightly called the lifeline or arteries of a nation because economic development of a country depends on the well-developed and efficient means of transport and communication. They are indispensable for movement of people, goods and services from one place to another. They have contributed to socio-economic progress in many ways by connecting far-flung areas of the country. They have enriched all aspects of our life, social, culture, individual and economic. They promote trade, tourism and business, thus adding value to the economy. Transport and communication have made possible international trade, which is essential for every economy as no country is self-sufficient in all resources. They link areas of production with consumption, like agriculture farms are linked to the markets and industries. They help in the balanced regional development of a country. They play a very important role at the time of natural calamities, like for providing relief measures. Deficient areas can obtain resources from the region of surplus, thereby making the interdependence among the regions possible. They have added substantially to growing amenities and facilities for the comfort of life. Next question, why do the movement of goods and services from one place to another require fast and efficient means of transport? Explain with example. Answer, transport plays an important role in the economy. Because of transport, raw materials reach the factory and finished product reach to the consumer. The pace of development of a country depends upon the production of goods and services as well as their movement over space. Today, the world has converted into a large village with the help of efficient and fast-moving transport. Good transport helps in quick carrying of raw material from remote areas to the production center and allows distribution of goods efficiently. Transport helps in the development of communication. Various means of communication help us in interacting with other people in all the parts of the world. It has brought the world closer. Transport like railways help us in conducting various activities like business, sightseeing, pilgrimages, etc. Pipeline are used for transporting crude oil and natural gas to refineries and factories. Water provides the cheapest means of transport and is useful for international trade. Air transport provides the fastest, most comfortable mode of transport. Thus, it is clear that there are many advantages of transportation and communication. These means help in the development of the country, so they are rightly called the lifeline of a nation and its economy. Next question, examine the example, the role of means of transport and communication in making our life prosperous and comfortable. Answer, transport and communication have a major role to play in making our life prosperous and comfortable. Means of transport provide seamless movement of goods and people and thus facilitate various economic activities. Means of communication help in flow of information, which is necessary for proper management of supply chain and financial transactions. Today, we are living in the age of communication using telephone, television, film and internet. Even books, magazines and newspapers are important means of communication. Various means of transport and communication have reduced distances, bringing the world closer. Modern life is so complex that one has to depend on others. The same is true of the countries as well. No country today can prosper without the cooperation and assistance of others. This requires movement of goods and materials between countries. Trade provides us with our necessities and also adds to the amenities and comfort of our life. Transport like railways help us in conducting various activities like business, sightseeing, pilgrimage, and transportation of goods over longer distances. Water provides the cheapest means of transport and is useful for international trade. Air transport provides the fastest, most comfortable mode of transport. Pipelines are used for transporting crude oil and natural gas of refineries and factories. Thus, means of transport and communication put life into a nation and its economy. Hence, they are called the lifeline of a nation and its economy. Next question, write the characteristics of superhighways, national highways and state highways. Answer, superhighways. These are 6-lane roads built by National Highway Authority of India, NHAI, under the road development project launched by the government. The major objective of these roads is to reduce time and distance between the megacities of India, especially the Golden Quadrilateral, which links Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai. Other important roads developed by NHAI are North-South Corridor linking Srinagar in the north and Kanyakumari in the south, and East-West Corridor linking Porbandar in Gujarat to Silchar in Assam. National highways. These are the primary road system which run in the north-south and east-west direction, connecting all the states and link extreme parts of the country. These roads are led and maintained by the central government. like Central Public Works Department, CPWD, as they are of national importance. The historical Sher Suri Marg, now called National Highway No. 1, links Delhi and Amritsar, and the longest highway in the country, in National Highway No. 7, which links Banarsi and Kanyakumari. State highways. Roads linking state capitals with different districts' headquarters are known as state highways. These roads are constructed and maintained by State Public Works Department, PWD, in states and union territories. The expenditure or cost and maintenance of these roads is the responsibility of the respective state government. Next question. Why is road transport more useful than rail transport in India? Give reasons. Or roadways still have an edge over railways in India? Give reasons. Answer. Roadways score over railways. Construction of road is easier and cheaper as compared to railways. Roads provide door-to-door service. Thus, the cost of loading and unloading is much lower as compared to railways, which generally leave the people and goods at the distant railway station. Roads can negotiate higher gradients of slope and as such can traverse through mountains, terrain, but railways cannot negotiate steep gradients. Road transport is economical in transportation of few person and relatively small amount of goods over short distances. Road transport is also used as a feeder to other modes of transport. They provide link between railway station, airports and seaports. They link agriculture farms with markets and industries, thus linking rural and urban areas. Next question. Why is the distribution of roads not uniform in India? Explain with example. Answer. Distribution of roads in not uniform in India due to different types of geographical features. Moreover, the volume of traffic as well as passengers also affect road networking in India. Roads are highly congested in cities. Most of the bridges and culverts have become narrow, old and broken. Some roads are metalled, that is well built, and brick and cement, and about half of the roads are unmetalled, especially in rural areas, which makes them inaccessible during rainy season. The regions with rugged terrain have steep roads with lots of hairpin bends. Next question. Railways play an important role in Indian economy. Give supportive arguments or explain the importance of railway as the principal mode of transportation for freight and passengers in India. Answer. Railways are the principal mode of transportation for freight and passengers in India as they link different parts of the country. They carry used loads and bulky goods to long distances. Railways make it possible to conduct multiple activities like business, tourism, pilgrimage, along with goods transportation over longer distances. Railways have been a great integrating force for the nation. For more than 150 years now, they have been helpful in binding the economic life of the country and also promoted cultural fusion. They have accelerated the development of the industry and agriculture. Next question. Describe the distribution of the railway network in India. Answer. The Indian Railway have a network of 7,031 stations spread over the country. The route length is 63,221 km. It has a fleet of 7,817 locomotives. There are 5,321 passenger service vehicles. The number of coaches vehicle in 4,904. We have 2,28,170 wagons, which run on the total rail track of 1,08,486 km. Next question. Which factor affects the distribution pattern of the railway network in the country? Answer. Factors that affect the distribution pattern of railway network in India. Physical factors, the nature of terrain and the number of rivers running through the region will determine the density of railway network in that region. For example, mountains, marshy, sandy and forested areas have sparse network, whereas plain areas have dense network of the railway. Economic factor. Regions which have rich resources and are economically more developed have denser network of railways in comparison to the region with low economic development. Administrative factors. The administrative and political decisions also affect the distribution of railway network in a region. Next question. Analyze the physiographic and economic factors that have influenced the distribution pattern of the railway network in our country. Or the distribution pattern of Indian railway network is influenced by the physiographic factors. Examine this statement. Answer. Factors that affect the distribution pattern of railway network in India. Physiographic factor. The northern plain with vast level land, high population density and rich agricultural resources provide most favorable condition for railway network. The nature of terrain and the number of rivers running through the region determine the density of railway network in that region. Mountain, marshy, sandy and forested areas have sparse network, whereas plain areas have dense network of the railways. It was difficult to lay railway lines on the sandy plains of the western Rajasthan, swamps of Gujarat and forested tract of Madhya Pradesh. Economic factors. Regions which have rich resources and are economically more developed have denser network of railways in comparison to the region with low economic development. Administrative factors. The administrative and political decision also affect the distribution of railway network in a region. Next question. List four factors which favored the development of dense network of railway in the northern plain. Answer. Four reasons for dense network of railway in northern plain are: the vast level land provided the most favorable condition for their growth. It is cheaper and easier to construct railway track here. The agriculture and industrial development in this region necessitated the development of railway lines. High population density in this region further required the development of railway lines. Resources such as iron and steel fuels, etc., required for the development of railways are available in the abundance in the northern plain.